Greetings, ant lovers. Welcome to the AntsCanada YouTube channel and yet another ant video. I'm Mikey Bustos, aka AntsCanada, and this is a video about my newest ant colony and project, my Oecophylla smaragdina colony, commonly known as Asian weaver ants. Weaver ants are definitely among the coolest species I've ever owned, and I'm housing them in my living room of my condo here in Manila, Philippines. The species is native to Asia and Australia and is completely arboreal, so I designed a 2-foot by 2-foot by 3-foot tall enclosure just for them. And within it, I've planted some sapling fruit trees. You see, these weaver ants are cool because they build their homes by pulling leaves in these trees together, and they sort of glue them in place by using the silk secreted by their larvae. You'll get to see this really cool process of weaving their leaf nests together later on in this video, so be sure to watch till the end. Okay, so let's start with how this colony first started. This species is very common in Manila, and with the help of a friend, I was able to acquire 2 weaver ant nests collected from a single guayabano tree in a yard. If you look here, you'll see that these ants are kept in their open-top setup by way of a petroleum jelly laid on thick, both vertically and upside down. Lucky for me, Vaseline actually works to keep these ants inside. The plants I've chosen for this setup are calamansi, a small green citrus fruit, there on the left of the screen, and a young chico tree, there towards the upper right. You can see the guayabano nest clipping secured there on the bottom right. It seems here in the Philippines, these ants prefer to nest in fruit trees, so in housing these ants, I had the challenge of having to grow small trees in an indoor setup. My hope was to try to bonsai these trees by cutting them back as they grew to sort of dwarf them. Weaver ants aren't really a commonly kept ant species, and though there have been a few blogs and articles about them, it seems little is known about their captive care, so I knew I had to sort of improvise as I went along. Now, I knew the vitality of these ants depended greatly on the vitality of the trees that they were to inhabit, so housing young trees in an indoor setup meant that my lighting needed to be just right. This setup sits right in front of a north-facing window that receives direct morning sunlight for about 2 hours, so I have a spotlight on after that to provide the plants with continued light for the entire day. Large screen ventilation holes were cut out in 4 areas at the sides of the enclosure so that the enclosure doesn't get stuffy or stagnant. Now, I knew these ants were very energetic ants, so from day one, I provided the colony with a bowl of cotton soaked with sugar water to give them the energy the workers needed, and they instantly took to that. I also noticed that they keep the bowl clean of debris. Sometimes flower petals from the calamansi tree fall into the bowl, and I noticed that the workers will carry this debris away to dispose of somewhere else. Perhaps the ants recognize that they need to keep this sugar source as clean as possible. One of the things I found very interesting was their willingness to forage at ground level. While a lot of the ants foraged up high in the enclosure, there were still many, many workers willing to come down to ground level to visit the sugar bowl and look for food. In fact, the workers would not leave any corner of the enclosure unsearched. The ants were very active both in the day and in the night. Now, you might have noticed those giant test tubes hanging there towards the back. I've placed those there to provide water if ever they needed to drink. I also wanted to place those test tubes there in case the ants didn't want to move into the trees that I provided them, as I knew from past experience that a weaver ant colony living in a wilting home, which eventually would happen to the guayabano tree clippings, would eventually move into a giant test tube if it was provided to them. So those test tubes were there to also provide a sort of backup home in case they didn't want to move into the calamansi or chico trees. For the substrate, I wanted to use something light and water absorbent, so I chose coconut husk as a filler. But the trees themselves are grown in rich soil and were kept in the plant bags in which they were sold. So I just basically covered these plant bags with this coconut husk and with some sphagnum moss. This means that to water the trees, I needed to water the soil directly at their base. I also make sure to spray the plants every evening or whenever it rains outside here in Manila. I use purified water so that unsightly calcium deposits don't form on the acrylic. Alright, so enough about the setup. Let's move on to the ants. Feeding the colony sugars was quite easy, but protein was sort of a challenge. The ants would not take superworms or mealworms, and at first, they liked feeder roaches, but eventually, it got to the point where sometimes they would eat them, and at other times, I discovered that the ants would just dispose of them somewhere. Here you can see the ants seizing a cockroach nymph. Weaver ants use a cool tactic of grabbing their prey from all sides, using their mandibles, and also using those strong legs, which specialize in gripping surfaces, and they just pull. The weaver ants stretch the prey item until it either rips it apart or dies from being sprayed with formic acid. Now, I've cared for many, many ants in the past, but there's something really unique about these ants that I find really appealing. Perhaps it's because it seems like they've got large projects in their mind. Like they're always busy with something. Just look at them. It looks like they've each got a certain project duty to do. Very big plans. During the daytime, I love watching them. They do some really cool, unique behaviors that I've never seen in any other ant. One of these behaviors is the way they form these long chains using only their bodies. You can see them starting off here. It starts with just a few members, and then it grows and grows. Really kind of neat. But sometimes, they change their mind and it dissolves. They really are so funny, and they have such character. Now you might notice the size difference of the workers. There are some workers which are really large, perhaps over 1 centimeter long, and some that are really, really tiny. Some as small as under 0.5 centimeter. It's the smaller ants that hang around the nest and specialize in taking care of the brood and of the queen. Most of the ants that venture out of the nest to forage are the larger ants. Whatever the case, these ants are pretty darn cool. So finally, onto what these weaver ants are famous for: nest building. As their name suggests, these ants are masters at weaving leaf baskets, or more like gluing leaf nests, together. And it was definitely something I was looking forward to observing in keeping these ants. I did have my doubts though, because in the past I'd failed getting these ants to nest on plants both fake and real, and I also wasn't sure if the ants would be willing to move into sapling trees as opposed to full-grown trees as they would in the wild. I also didn't know if they were willing to transfer tree species. This colony was collected from a guayabano tree, but I was hoping they would transfer to either my calamansi tree or my chico tree. Either way, I made sure to provide the colony with lots of sugar water just to provide them the energy they needed in case they needed to create a nest. And then, on the fourth night of them living with me in my arboreal setup, something truly magnificent happened. The weaver ants decided to nest build into the chico tree. I freaked out! I went to grab my camera and tried to film as much of it as I could. The best part about it was the ants couldn't have chosen a better place to build their nest. Right in a corner against the acrylic, which meant I could see and film everything. Just watching those worker ants gripping onto the leaves, pulling them into place, while other ants grabbed larvae to glue those leaves together, a process that up to that point I'd only seen on TV and in videos. But being able to witness them in real life was truly an honor. The moment was magical, humbling, and I felt truly honored to be able to witness such a fantastic event. It's definitely something I'll never forget. And so, the next day, to celebrate such a titanic event, I gave my colony a new food manger and some crickets. And turns out, the ants love crickets. And behold, their final construction that came together in just a single night. Fantastic. I couldn't believe I could see everything inside the nest. Larvae, pupae, workers, everything. I could even see ants that were eating some of the crickets. It was just fascinating. Check them out, guys. Look at how busy they are in there. It's packed. The thing that I found cool was that the webbing was used for more than just gluing the leaves together. They actually used their larvae to spin silk walls and create floors, which lined each chamber. It was just amazing architecture. To me, creating something like this overnight is comparable to erecting a skyscraper way up high into the mountains in just 10 hours. Every night, I peek into the nest, and I discover that there's always something new. There's always some new brood in there. A new room, a new floor, a new leaf glued onto the construction. It's really amazing to see the nest come together. And I know what some of you might be thinking. Have I seen the queen? Well, no, I haven't. But you know what? I'm okay with that. They've given me such an amazing peek into their private lives, and I know that they've stuck cameras into these weaver ant nests before, but it really is different having them in your living room. Discovering these weaver ants and discovering how they live has truly been a fascinating experience for me as an ant keeper. And every night as I watch these ants swarm as a single colony, it really secures in my mind why I love keeping ants so much. They really are dynamic, industrious, and just all around cool. Thanks guys for watching this video, and please don't forget to comment, share, and subscribe to my videos. This is Ants Canada signing out. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching this video, and you guys know the drill. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to subscribe to our channel. Also, be sure to check out some of my other cool ant videos. I have a video on how to create an epic ant farm, particularly for you beginners out there. I also have an unboxing and instructional video of our newest formicarium product. Be sure to also check out our awesome Lacius Neoniger playlist and our Campanatus novibor playlist. It's ant love forever!